Good.
All right, let's turn our attention to tonight. It could be a historic one in Carolina for Sebastian Aho. If he's able to extend his point streak to 12, he will pass Ron Francis' record for the longest point streak to start a season in franchise history as the Canes take on the Bruins tonight. For more on that game, we say hello to Mike Maniscalco. Mike, Coach Rod Brind'Amour confirmed that Scott Darling will be making his first start of the season tonight. What should we expect to see from him?
Well, hopefully, if you're a Canes fan, you're going to see exactly what we saw in the preseason, where Scott was very good. He dedicated himself to an off-season workout program with strength and conditioning coach Bill Berniston. He was in great shape. Last preseason game, he tweaks his leg against Nashville. He makes a rehab start, though, the other day, Wednesday, in Utica for the Charlotte Checkers. He faces 26 shots. He makes 25 saves, and he looked really good. All of the reports that we had had good mobility, good movement. I talked to Scott a lot leading up to this game. He says he's in a good spot. He's anxious. This is an opening night for him, so he might be a little excited to start this game, but he's ready to get back in the pipes.
Oh, I bet. All right, tonight the Canes, though, taking on one of the toughest offenses in the entire league. That top line is one of the best in the NHL. How does the Canes' top line plan on countering it?
Well, you know, I think that's the funny thing. Everybody comes into this game, and you have to talk about the Patrice Bergeron line for Boston. But Sebastian Aho, as you mentioned right off the top, Jackie, he's on an 11-game point streak for the Carolina Hurricanes. And he, with Michael Ferland, who you and Darren and EJ were talking about, have just been a great fit. And then Teuvo Teravainen, who he's got all of that chemistry with, the two Finns together, they've turned into this great top line. So I'm actually going to be a little bit interested to see what do the Bruins try to do to counter this offensive line. So it might be a little the best defense tonight is whoever has the best offense with their top line.
Well, I believe, too, the Carolina Hurricanes are allowing the least shots per game in the NHL, so that should help them tonight as well. Dougie Hamilton off to a bit of a slow start in his new city, facing a former team of his tonight. Is he finally starting to settle in Carolina?
Yeah, I think he is, without a doubt, Jackie. And I think part of it is, you know, it's a move. It's a new system. You've got to learn a new defensive partner. And, you know, the Carolina Hurricanes have almost a new coaching staff, as Rod Brind'Amour was promoted to be the head coach. And now you've got Dean Chenault running the defense. So everybody's had to get a little bit acclimated with each other. But Dougie gets his first goal as a Carolina Hurricane the other day. He gets named the second star. He's not afraid to floss, as we saw post-game. So he's got the moves. But I really think for him, it's been settling down, finding his way around the area, which he's now doing, and not only that, settling in with his defensive partner. He's been physical the last few games defensively. He's been very, very good, and we know the offense is going to come for number 19, and I think we're starting to see that as far as this team settling down, especially 5-on-5. Maybe if he can get it going offensively on the power play, where the Canes are at the bottom of the league, we'll start to see those numbers tick up a little bit. But Rod Brind'Amour is not worried about that. He thinks the power play is getting chances because of guys like Dougie Hamilton being able to create them.
Well, you mentioned the post-game floss dance, so let's talk about the fun this Carolina Hurricanes team is having. The post-win celebrations are fun. They're epic. It looks like the players are having a good time. What is the team saying about their new approach to the game?
They love it. And, Jackie, it's a game. It's supposed to be fun. And seeing we're here in the Triangle in Durham, North Carolina, is about 20 minutes down the road. The great movie Bull Durham, where Crash Davis told everybody, "It's a game. Let's have some fun." So this team is having some fun. And for everybody who knows, it's been a long time for the Carolina Hurricanes to have that kind of excitement and jump in the building. They haven't made the playoffs since the 08-09 season. But fans are now sticking around to the end of the game. You know, nobody's doing the L.A. rush to the parking lot to get home a little bit early. They want to see what the team is going to do. It's brought a different kind of electricity into this building. And you know, who doesn't like to loosen up the tie and have some fun every now and again?
Oh, I hear you, man. I got to say, I mean, the boys are beside me right now. They're loosening their ties as you say that.
Exactly.
They agree with you 100%. But you know what? We love seeing the Carolina Hurricanes have a good time. I'm a big fan of the post-game row. I thought that one was well played.
Stay tuned, because I have no idea. They kind of do like spur of the moment. I have no idea what the next celebration is going to be. So everybody here in Carolina is hoping for wins so we can keep seeing what the next thing is going to be.
My goodness, the intrigue is so real. Thanks for this. We appreciate it. Enjoy the game tonight.